Hello everyone, and thanks for joining in today. My name is Dominic, and in this talk, I want to give a quick overview of our paper titled Cloudy, a Chance of Misconceptions. Office solutions are a common sight on today's computers. So common, in fact, that you probably can recognize some, if not all, of these icons. Fairly recently, a shift is happening from local-only solutions towards online apps. Cloud-based solutions are so prevalent now that you likely have no problems answering the following question. When did you last use an online office application? For me personally, that's an easy question. I created the slides for this talk in an online office app, so my answer would be right now. But even if you don't use an online office app to process your documents or emails, you are probably not safe from having your information processed online. Cloud-based office software is now widely deployed and used by companies, governments, and even schools. And while cloud-connected office software has many perks, such as ease of access and sharing, it introduces many new security and privacy challenges, formerly not found in their offline equivalents. Especially concerning is the storage of cloud data, which relates back to the access rights and the data safety. Last year, for example, a German data protection commissioner banned Microsoft's Cloud Office app from schools due to collected telemetry and potential access by US officials. And while the specific case was resolved by placing dedicated servers directly within Germany, it highlights nonetheless the changed playing field for security and privacy in the now cloud-connected office apps. This is where our work comes in. We wanted to investigate if and how users interact with cloud office applications, what their awareness, perceptions, and attitudes are about security and privacy in cloud office apps, and what their understandings, basic mental models are regarding protection, security, and access of their cloud office data. For this, we developed a survey consisting of 9 sections containing quantitative and some qualitative aspects. Our survey had 2 versions, one in English with a US focus and a good German-speaking version. We pre-tested our survey with native speakers in both English and German and ran a number of pre-surveys with a total of 29 participants. We conducted our surveys on Amazon's Mechanical Turk and ClickWorker, the equivalent for German-speaking countries. After filtering, we had 200 final participants, 105 from MTurk and 95 from ClickWorker. I now want to give you a quick overview over some of our findings. Due to the short time of this talk and the wide area covered in our survey, I still recommend having a look at our paper for a more in-depth discussion. Overall, online office usage is quite prevalent among our participants, which often use the Google Drive or Microsoft Office 365 suites. Although the German-speaking participants still prefer offline Microsoft Office by a slight margin. Unsurprisingly, our participants prefer to store their documents on the platform they edit them with, that being in the cloud for online apps and locally for offline office software. Our participants agree on the benefits of cloud office software, free access without installation, and easy collaboration. They seem to be aware of some security implications of processing their documents and emails in the cloud, and overall prefer their local system in terms of security against unauthorized access. Although some assumptions regarding cloud security seem to be somewhat less developed. In case of unauthorized access of their documents, most of our participants think it's the cloud provider's responsibility to inform them via email of the breach. So, with my 5 minutes almost at their end, I only have time for a quick summary. We were interested in the interaction of users with cloud office software, their perception of privacy and security, and their overall understanding of protection and access of their cloud documents. To investigate this, we conducted 2 surveys with a total of 200 participants on Amazon's MTurk and the German-speaking ClickWorker. Overall, we find that our participants are aware of basic general security, storage, and access implications, although some basic threat models seem to be underdeveloped due to a lack of technical knowledge. And with that, thanks for joining in. My name is Dominic, and this was an overview over Cloudy with the Chance of Misconceptions.